If you use the internet and are worried about security, one of the best things you can do after backing up your data is to install a virtual private network, or VPN. A VPN is a secure, encrypted connection made directly from your computer, laptop, or mobile device to the person or server you're connecting with. Large companies use VPNs to ensure that their data is fully encrypted and protected, and so can you. If you've ever used a public Wi-Fi hotspot, the connection from your computer to the Wi-Fi is wide open for hacking and for the installation of spyware or malware. The solution? Install a VPN. If you're concerned about people snooping on your data, then install a VPN. Your IP address will change, effectively hiding your computer from any snoopers. And if you're traveling overseas and want your browser to behave as if it's in your home country, then install a VPN and connect directly with a server at home. There is a downside. A poor VPN can severely reduce your download speed. But if you choose a good provider, the impact won't be too bad, and it's a small price to pay for peace of mind. There are many VPN providers to choose from. Some of them are free, but the best ones charge a small monthly fee. It's up to you to choose, and in this short video, we'll show you how to install a VPN on your laptop or mobile device. The first step is to choose your VPN supplier. I already have a contract with a VPN supplier, IPVanish, so I'll use that to show you how easy it is to install. Open up your browser and log in to your provider. Next, you'll need to download and install a small encryption tool on your local machine. Here, IPVanish makes it easy for you by checking your machine and providing the correct software. Simply agree the license terms, pay their fee, I've already done this, click on the download button and follow the instructions. IPVanish installs the tool on my computer and asks me to log into my account. Once logged in, I get to choose my connection. You'll see that without the VPN, I'm currently working from Bangkok, not the most secure country in the world. So I can choose which country to connect to. I choose the UK. I can choose one of the major cities if I want, and even the server, but I'll leave that to the software, which will choose the fastest connection. The VPN tool gives me some other useful information. I can choose from a list of servers in different countries. I can check my account status, and I can modify the settings. Do I want the VPN to run from startup, or do I want to select it myself when needed? I want to choose when to use the VPN. I can quite happily use a local Bangkok server for things that don't require a high level of security and thereby get a faster speed. We'll see how much faster in a moment. And finally, I can review the terms of service if I want to. So, let's connect to the UK. I simply choose the country and click Connect. Windows tells me I'm connected, and a moment later I can see that my IP address has changed and that the internet world thinks I'm now in Nottingham, UK, rather than Bangkok, Thailand. And my connection from Bangkok to the UK is encrypted and a lot more secure. To disconnect, I just click the disconnect button. It really is that easy, and it only costs a few dollars a month. But what about that download speed? There is a downside. Here's what my internet speed looks like without the VPN connected. I'm using a local server here, a nice 3 microsecond ping, 21.5 megabytes per second download, and nearly 2.5 upload. That's not bad. Now let's connect the VPN. The first thing you notice is that all the adverts on the speed tester are now in English. And the second is that the download speed is about one-third of what it was before. And I can always turn off the VPN and return to a local server if I want. In short, a VPN is a great idea, even if you don't travel much. It will hugely increase your security for only a small financial outlay and a slightly larger reduction in connection speed. If you'd like more information, contact eTop Technology. We're here to help. If you like these videos, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you found this video helpful, check out some of our more recent videos. And if you're looking for a new IT partner, please visit our website.